Hey, what's going on, guys? Krowsama here. Today is a day I've been looking forward to for so long, and it's because I've been working on this particular unicorn. It's the MGEX Gundam Unicorn Verka. I've been working on it for months, and it's really because I procrastinated for so long. I wasn't going into like the July slump and mentality I once had, but I'm telling you, I did not want to finish this. I really just wanted to put it aside and forget about it, but I persevered and I pushed through. It's complete. And today I'm actually repping the Gundam Unicorn shirt. I wish that I had more unicorn shirts because I actually really do love the unicorn design. I think it's fantastic. It's a beautiful looking design. And the MGEX basically makes this, to me, the definitive unicorn Gundam. Honestly, I know the Perfect Grade has the LEDs and it looks really good. It's large, but it's just something about this particular model that I absolutely love. So I'm not going to do like a showcase of the build process. Really, just going to show you some clips of the finished project, talk about my thoughts on it. Now, overall, I did not really have problems with the build in terms of the straight build and the painted build. And if you remember when I did the review, I did the review with the LEDs inside. Don't ever, ever do that. Don't review something that has LEDs on the inside as a straight build and dismantle it and take apart, you know, the LEDs and all that stuff, because you're really going to run the risk of doing any kind of shortage or some kind of damage to the strip. Luckily, because I'm a very competent person, a competent builder, I did not run into any issues when disassembling mine, but It was nerve-wracking, to say the least. So please be careful if you are going to be building this, whether it's a straight build or a painted build. Don't put it together and like, oh, look at it and try and like, you know, analyze it and do your little notes and everything and then disassemble it. Just, I would honestly say, cut the parts off the runner, do your sanding, do your editing and all your other modifications, and then put it together. Or if you are going to put it together, don't put the LED strip inside. Do like what Zach did. He actually built it, reviewed it, and did not have the LEDs, and he basically disassembled it, painted it all up, and then put the LEDs in. So that was actually a better route that he took, vice me putting the LEDs in there for the review itself. But hey, aside from that, this is a beautiful model kit, and I'm not going to say it's my best paint job because I made quite a bit of errors. Most of them, like, I don't even see them. You're probably not going to see them on camera, and I'm really not going to announce them because your eyes are going to be, like, focused on those particular areas. But there's certain things on here that I made mistakes on whenever I put it together. Because I didn't top coat it, there's a little bit of scraping of paint. But it's very, like, it's very hidden in certain locations. But regardless, you know, I'm still very content and happy with the end results. I think it looks great. A lot of my friends who looked at it or, you know, people online, they liked it. They, you know, they thought it looks great. I really haven't had anyone say anything negative. So, hey, you know, let me give myself a little pat on the back. I think I did a good job on this painted build. I did the traditional look. It's basically a white unicorn. And I'm going to tell you some of the things I did, right? So I did a flat white with the armor. I basically just did flat white, and then from there, I did a crystal blue, and I put that over the white, and then from there, I just did some gloss coats. That's really about it. I didn't do anything crazy to it. For the actual cycle frame, I did crystal coating of green, and I did a little bit of red here and there, but you really can't see the red, so you're going to see a lot of the green in the video. That's pretty much it. I didn't do anything special to this kit. The blue is just I think it's a pure blue. Yeah, I think the actual blue legs and the backpack, that's a pure blue. And then for the inner frame, that's actually a blue-gray. I went with the blue-gray because I thought it looked great. Now for the base, I just did, I think it was an airship gray, and I didn't do anything crazy to it. In all honesty, just painted it one tone. I did some highlighting with a lighter gray in certain areas. I laid down some of the Kotobukiya, like warning and caution tape. Put a couple of decals on there and did some wash, and that's it. So nothing spectacular with this kit. I just try to be as precise as possible. Probably one of the things that took a long time is the decals. It took me, I think, like 3 days because it's just a lot. It's a lot of decals, and I wanted to make sure I'm doing it all correctly. I didn't want to damage any decals, so I gave it proper time to cure, and I did some setter on there just that way it can be more adhesive to the parts. But other than that, everything came out great. I used nearly all the water slide decals, so that's why you see like so many decals all over. It's the Verka treatment, right? But that's it, man. I did some chrome for the thrusters and some clear blue on the tips. I want to do some clear purple or clear orange underneath that, but I decided to just go ahead and leave it as is. I thought it looked fine. That's it. I mean, what can I say? I think this came out good. I'm going to put it on the shelf in a case so that way it doesn't accumulate dust. And I really hope that one day maybe I can actually enter it in a contest, because I think this is actually a worthy enough kit to enter, even though it does have some discrepancies. But I'm going to take those discrepancies and just own it. You know, that's what this hobby is all about, guys. It's about making errors and just either living with it, or you fix it then and there, or you just fix it later. So I'm just taking it, and I'm going to address, you know, those kind of issues if I face them in my next build. And hopefully, as I keep progressing through this hobby, I get better and better. I mean, you can do a comparison with my first painted build and this one, and it's a night and day difference, honestly. So I'm happy, I'm very content, and it looks good. It's going to look good on the shelf, and you know, I think that's pretty much it. I don't have anything else I can really talk about it, except for I'm very happy, man. And I think that's something that I really enjoy about this hobby, is that you can do something, and you can have a physical like appreciation of it. So this is something I can always look at on the shelf and be like, you know what, I actually did that. And I'm happy with my end results. So I do think that everyone should try to, you know, appreciate your work regardless of the quality that you think it is. Hey, it's beautiful. You're a great builder. Keep on striving for excellence. And, you know, try and do better. That's all I can ever say is to take up something that's different, that's maybe a little bit uncomfortable, and become comfortable being uncomfortable. But that's it for me, guys. Thank you all for watching this kind of like random video. I know it is, but I will have some other good videos coming up very soon, so stay tuned for all those, and I'll be seeing you guys in the next video. And, oh, thanks again to all the sponsors, and thanks again to the members of the channel. I cannot do this without you guys. Thank you guys so much, and I'll be seeing you in the next video. Bye-bye.